Welcome back to Making Records with Eric Valentine. So this one, as you can see from the title, there's some stuff about working on signing. This is all kind of like just more day in the life, just family trying to build a barn studio stuff. It was very cool to see both of Grace's parents hanging out. So there's Sparky and Peggy in there helping bring in pieces of siding. We were doing this thing where it's shiplap siding, and we were using this stuff called weather wash that is supposed to make it look like, you know, it's been sitting out in the sun for years or whatever, and really looked beautiful when you put it on. The funny thing was, you know, it was a huge amount of siding on this building. It's a big structure. And so we wanted to apply this stuff all before it went up. It was, you know, it seemed easier to put it on before it was all, you know, on the building. And so we put it on all this stuff. And then the contractor installed all of the siding, did a beautiful job. It was all up there. And I would say within the first, 3 to 4 weeks of it being up there and the sun being on it, it all just turned yellow again. I couldn't believe it. You know, it's like this stuff is supposed to do exactly the opposite of that. It still looks great. I'm happy. It can be whatever color it wants to be. But boy, did that not work. It was, yeah, pretty bizarre. We first put it up, it was kind of this beautiful sort of grayish, you know, tint to it, you know, from this weather wash stuff. And it was in the sun for a little bit, all turned yellow. Boop. So just like that. So here it is, just hanging out, doing some siding stuff. You can see people bringing stuff in and out. There's a few different clips of this stuff going on. Here it is.
Now, why is the tomato?
Tomato is lost?
The tomato. Puzzle. And like this one.
Go, Bessie, go! Do it! Yay! We're doing it! So in this next little bit, you can see these huge windows. This was an idea of Grace's. I always say this, it's because it's true. Anything in this studio build that really looks beautiful and aesthetically pleasing was definitely Grace's idea. I just have no awareness of that stuff. And so these windows were her idea, and I love them. They're just gorgeous. And so you see those going in. We look at it from the outside, so you can see some of the new siding that had been put on. This was, I think, before it really got bleached out to be more yellow again. So you can kind of see the weather wash effect on there. And then, you know, a little bit of Mama, you know, razzing me as she always enjoys doing. So here that is.
Daddy,
feeling pretty excited.
Yeah,
looks pretty sexy over there.
You get some windows going in.
That's some good stuff, right?
Sorry, birds, you don't get to live here anymore.
That's some serious tempered low E glass right there.
Yeah, you're some tempered low E glass.
Yeah, I know.
All right. We got siding going up, Dad. How do you feel?
You know, I feel pride for my family, for the property, for the bar. The windows are so cool.
They look gorgeous. Sunday
showcase looks from the inside out.
Wow, look at that. Mm-hmm. Got yourself some winders. This barn looks completely different than the day we bought it.
this is really cool too. I'm glad this happened.
Absolutely. Yeah, you want to be in a sunlit, if you're going to be the one that's stuck in a hole as a drummer or a vocalist.
Stuck in the isolation booth.
No more isolation.
It's like being in the hole when you're in prison.
Yeah. No nature, no contact with humankind.
At least the hole has a window here.
Hell yeah, it does. Your hole has a window. And we are officially going to be a... Oh, I know, the opening. That's the thing. We're going to officially be a commercially zoned...
Public space.
Official. You're public. You're a public official.
Yeah, I know.
So this next thing's kind of interesting. It's my continued efforts to try and figure out what is going on with the overflow drain in the pond. And so I decided I just needed to see what's going on down there. So I taped my iPhone to a big stick and stuck the stick all the way down. And this thing's probably, I don't know, maybe a little over 6 feet deep, something like that. And just put it down there and just kind of rotated it around so I could see what was going on down there. And it was pretty revealing. Check this out. Okay, so you can see the opening where the water goes out and ultimately feeds out back into the little brook that runs through the property. But there's huge cracks down there. And the cracks is where all the water is getting in underneath the actual, you know, overflow drain. The water's really supposed to spill over the top. There's giant cracks at the bottom, and I guess through seepage or something or whatever, the water just gushes in underneath there, and I believe that's ultimately how the fish got out. and so later on, I adventured to try and patch all of that. That was an interesting experience. I don't think I have any footage of it because all hands were full. I guess I'll just explain it now. So what I ended up doing was the thing's only about, you know, about 2 feet in diameter. And so all you can do is basically just go down in there. But once you're in there, it's too narrow to be able to like lift your arms up or crouch down or do anything. You're just kind of like slotted into this tube. And so I went down head first with a bucket of this water sealing cement. And I had Grace and her dad, Sparky, holding onto my feet so I wouldn't fall all the way down in there, and went down in and would just scoop out cement with my hand and just went with my hand and patched up all those cracks at the bottom of it. And it actually worked quite well. It patched up most of it. There's still one tiny little thing, but after I did that, in the next round of this, I was able to get the water to actually go over the top of it. There was still some water coming in over the, you know, underneath, but way, way less, and it was too small of an opening. So the fish are no longer actually getting out through the bottom, I'm happy to announce. But there's a whole other problem that arose. So I think I do have footage of the other problem, so we'll get to that. Okay, so there you have it. That was exterior siding and the overflow drain, just another step along the way of us trying to build this crazy barn studio thing. Okay, so next week, episode 11, it's going to shift gears a little bit. So along the way, I was gearing up to make another record and really wanted to have a different experience. And so this is the magic moment when I got this RCA BC2B tube console that I've been talking about a bunch. And so this was my first round of doing some work on it to try and refurbish it. And so you will be able to see the beginnings of that whole adventure in the next episode. All right, I'll see you then. Bye.